guys, you're welcome. If you're new here, thank you so much for passing by, and I hope you will subscribe. And if you're returning and you're a subscriber, thank you so much for your support. Yeah, so today we're just going to be talking about being a young mom. Okay, so I don't know, we can make this a coffee date, a conversation over the coffee. So just grab yourself some coffee, and I have mine here. Yeah, and let's talk, let's chat. So I think it's one of the conversations that we had with my friends. Guys, excuse me if the sound, if you can hear the sound. There are birds. There are birds over in the corner and they're fighting. And yeah, excuse me for that. I hope this stops soon. Anyway, so yeah, it's a conversation that we've had with my friends. Just how tough it is being a young mother. Honestly, having a child at a very young age, you know, in our late teens, some of us, you know. So I just thought I could share, you know, in case there's somebody out there who wants to have a child, or their boyfriend wants them to have a child for them, or whatever. You know, relationships are different, I know that. And yeah, I think life is different for everyone, you know. So I'm just gonna share my story, and I think I'll put it in pointers, you know, because I knew this before I had a child, because I didn't even plan to have a child, you know. So yeah, I think with all my friends, none of us plan to have kids. So yeah, I think the first one I'm just gonna talk about is gonna be finances. Hey guys, a child is expensive. A child is very, very expensive. And like I said, I had a child when I fell pregnant when I was doing my first year at university. So then I was only earning like 1,400 bula, which is basically supposed to be like my school money for me to survive, or going to school, you know, buy lunch at school, you know, transport and all that, you know, assignments, printing things and all that, you know. But I had to divide that money into buying stuff for Riley. So you can imagine how that was, you know. I think from the moment you get pregnant, you find out you're pregnant, you know, if your pregnancy is one that's kind of demanding, you know, cravings, you have to feed those. That takes money, a lot of money, because I don't think you can't control it. Honestly, you can't control it, you know. If you want to have Setswana food, like I ate Setswana food throughout my pregnancy. So if you want Setswana food, it's kind of expensive to get it, you know. So you're gonna have to feed those cravings, you know, before we even get to the child being born. So when we get to the child being born, it's like nappies, it's milk, if you're not gonna breastfeed, if you're gonna stop at one point, you know, it's clothes. They change clothes, like clothes don't fit them for a long time. I think every 2 months or so, you know, the baby would be like 3 months and start wearing 3 to 6 months clothes, and that means money, you know. Changes in the weather, you need to upgrade every single season, you need to be buying clothes. So you can imagine all that. Also, I think if you're gonna be a student, obviously you can't be home all the time, you're gonna have to engage a nanny. That's money, okay? So it's a lot, honestly, it's a lot. Your confinement, or botsetsi, as we call it, you know, that requires money as well, because you are eating bomodoro and all that, okay? Probably bring, you know, for me, Memogolo was the one who was taking care of me, you know, in confinement. So yeah, that's money. So yeah, actually, for me, I had a child with somebody who was not working, you know, was 2 years older than me. So if I was doing my best, you can do the math. So yeah, it was rough, it was difficult, and I feel like we even put our parents in, you know, in a tough space financially. Like, they had to adjust. We were still kids ourselves, we were still taken care of by our parents, you know. But then bringing a child is like you're bringing more baggage to that, you know. So our parents had to adjust our budgets as well to be able to help us, because you can't just watch your child suffer, if I put it that way, you know. You're gonna have to help them in a way. So yeah, I think it was difficult. It still is difficult, because now she has to go to school, you know, soon to start primary school, and that's a lot of money. Your girl's not working, so you can imagine who's paying for all these things, you know. So as much as I can try, you know, I'm not at that stage yet where I can say, no, I'm taking care of my child by myself. No, I am literally surviving with Riley off people's money, our parents. That is so, it's not nice, honestly, having to ask. As much as they can, say that, no, I'll take care of this and that, you feel bad. You will feel bad because sometimes you think, if it wasn't for me, my parents wouldn't be going through this financial crisis. So I think that's one thing, honestly, that we need to consider. I don't know if you know consider, but yeah, it's one of those things. And then the second thing, I think it changes your social life. I don't know if you guys have seen this thing trending on social media about, like, when you want to see your real friend, something like that, for pregnant, something like, it says something like that, that thing is so true. Like, when I found out I was pregnant, I lost some of my friends. I had nobody to talk to, obviously, because then, was those days, the clubbing days, the, all that, and I couldn't do that no more, because your girl was supposed to be home, because I'm pregnant. Okay, so I lost friends. I felt like I was alone in that time, Okay, not alone. I think I had two friends who were there for me, like, would talk, they'd ask me, like, how are you doing? How's the cravings doing and all that, So, yeah, I had a few friends, but I lost most friends, My baby shower, when the time came, some didn't even contribute money. It was a mess. But I think that separation is much needed. Just to know who's really got your back and who doesn't have your back. But like I'm saying, you are still a child, then you are still in those years where you should be grooving and, finding out what's going on with your life, socializing with your friends and all that. But it honestly stops. I don't want to lie to you. I think the minute I found out I was pregnant, I had to stop every single thing. Even though I wasn't showing, I couldn't be going to the club. I felt so bad doing that. Like, I'm carrying this child and here I am going to the club. It didn't make sense. And since it was my first year, I was still excited about getting my allowance and stuff like that. So, my friends and I had this shop. It's closed now. So we used to go there. Like, literally, when our allowance would report today, we are going shopping with that money. Despite the fact that it's for, our school. We'll see, cross that bridge when we get to it. So we'd go shopping, buy ourselves, stuff. Nice things, because, wow. It was sort of like a first salary thing for us. So I was like, oh my God, wow, money, it's here. So immediately I found out I was pregnant, that had to stop, literally. So when allowance gets in, I'm with my friends, they're doing that shopping, obviously. I want to do that, but I can't, because your girl, hello, we're going to be sharing this money with Riley, So I then started, trying to lay by some clothes for her and do this and that, just trying to save up as much as I can. And I did save up, so I feel like somehow that took away from my childhood. Is it childhood? Yeah, teenhood, whatever you call it, man, that thing. So I feel like in a way it changes that. So yeah, hey, it's tough, guys. It's really, really tough. And the other thing has to be balancing school, because like I'm saying, I'm talking about having a child at a young age. Most of us are in school then, and it doesn't start after the baby is born. It honestly starts from the time you're pregnant. For me, my first trimester, I slept a lot. Like, literally, I'd bath, I'm getting ready, I'm going to school, I'm motivated to go to school. I walk out the house, I come back. I get back in the house, I get back in my blankets, and I'm sleeping. Imagine. That's how bad it is. Like, you just sleep. You will sleep anyway. I know people, you are working, you are sleeping in your car or under the desk. Somewhere, you just want to sleep all the time. So you can imagine, assignments are there. They're not going to wait for you. Exams are coming. They're not going to wait for you. They're not going to be postponed for you. So you have to do that. You need valid reasons to actually go to the tertiary school funding thing, just to pause. So you it's a long process. It's a long process. So you're just gonna have to go through with it, And I think just the stress of having to sort of pause your school because of pregnancy, allowance obviously stops. How are you gonna take care of your child? So you're like, I'll see what to do. I'll balance things, So it was a tough time, guys. It was a tough time. I think I realized I was pregnant during, I think it was almost that assignment submission time. And your girl was so sleepy. I literally did assignments like last minute, and I was just My friends are actually helping me with that. That's why I said, I think I said in my graduation speech that, you know what, this is my degree with my friends, because if it wasn't for them, I honestly would not be having this degree. So yeah, at least luckily for me, I had, you know, classmates who really cared, you know, they'd fill me in and stuff like that, you know, just send me texts, oh no, this is what we did, you know, emails there and there about the notes, and just so I can try and catch up from home. So it was really, really tough balancing that. And then after the whole pregnancy, now getting to the childbirth, I gave birth during my second year, first semester. Hey guys, I've been waiting. I think Riley was overdue. Yeah, so I was waiting. I couldn't go to school then because, wow, I was about to pop anytime. So I just decided, you know what, I'll wait at home. I think that was one mistake I made, but anyway, I felt like I should do it then, and I did. So I sat at home and waited for, you know, to give birth. And guys, when I came back to school, our lecture was literally launching an assignment. I didn't understand a thing, literally. And I went to school, guys. I was 2 weeks. I think I got on a 2 weeks break. Yes, I think I got a 2 weeks break after delivering, literally. I was gonna be 2 weeks on Saturday, and the Friday before that, I went to school because the lecture was launching an assignment and something I couldn't miss. So I just went, I recorded the whole thing. I didn't understand because I didn't attend any lecture and I didn't even know. I failed that module, guys. I failed it. I failed so bad. You know, like, it has actually affected me trying to do my ACCA. I had to redo that module because it wasn't at par with what ACCA requires. So, I get it. So it was very tough, guys. It was really, really difficult having to catch up. And then when the baby is here, there's no time for you to say, I'm gonna read or I'm gonna do this, you know? Obviously our parents, my mom was there as well as my memuholo, like I said, my aunt. So they were there. Obviously my aunt would be helping me out during the day. My mom had to go back to work because she can't get a long leave, as if it's her maternity leave, you understand? So she just got a leave nyana to help me out, and then when it was time for her to go back to work, she went back to work. So my aunt would help me with the baby during the day, you know, she'd be doing laundry, doing just stuff that, you know, we do in Botsetsi, so confinement, that is. So it was difficult. At night when I'm trying to read and catch up, my aunt is asleep, she has to rest. My mom is asleep, she has to rest because she's going to work the following day. And I have to be up all night, okay? So all day, all night, I am awake. I did not sleep during that time. I didn't sleep because I thought, if I'm gonna fail, what am I going to do? You know, imagine my mom having to take care of me and Riley and then pay for, you know, me to go back and rewrite some modules at school. So I really, really had, I was literally those girls, you know, my child is at the back and I'm busy trying to study, you know. And honestly, there are those babies who just don't sleep at night. They are allergic to sleeping at night. So you can imagine, taking care of this baby, you are trying to read. It's a lot, guys. It's a mess. And when I tell you it's a very painful thing to go through, I am so serious. So yeah, I'm basically just having this conversation or doing this video just so if there's anyone out there, you know, you are not financially stable, you're still a student, you're still this and that, and you're considering having a baby, I just advise you to wait. Okay, wait on that because it's not nice. It is not easy, okay? I don't even know how I managed, I guess, by the grace of God, because, wow, I know. There's nothing I'd say I did, you know, that got me through. Nothing at all, like, nothing, because I was failing dismally, okay? I was failing at everything, so. And then that has also affected my body as well, my back, because I think we are supposed to be in the house, like, resting your back and stuff like that, just so your body can go back to its normal state, if it makes sense. Because you have your womb, you know, it's expanding to accommodate for the baby. So after that, you have to rest so that everything can go back into place, you know. So I felt dizzy almost all the time because of that. I think, hi guys, it was a mess. Imagine 2 weeks, stitches haven't even healed completely, you know, but I'm up and down going to school because I made a mistake. Okay, so I had to try and work it around, honestly. It was, I don't even know how to describe it, okay? That's the worst thing you can ever go through. And it doesn't even stop because when the child grows up, you know, the more they want your attention, the more they want your attention. You work in the house, you're from school, you know, maybe a year or two later, the child is crawling to you or running to you, you know. She wants your attention, or he wants your attention because you just got here, you're from school, there's no time to read, no time to do anything. And honestly, you can't take the burden of your child or take away from that bonding with your child and just literally dump it on your parents. Because like I'm saying, for me, my mom is working, she's still working, so she's the only one. You know, she's the only parents that I have. So imagine if I'm gonna go to school all day, like the whole day. So sometimes I even had to miss some lectures. Not that I didn't think they were important, but I felt like maybe with this one I could try and read it at night or watch the videos over YouTube or something, you know, anything really that could help, you know, because I had a child, you know, waiting for me at home. And then the monthly clinic visits as well, you know, sometimes she's booked at a time or dates where I'm supposed to be at school. You know, my classes started at 8 and I think government hospitals open at 7:30, but usually sometimes they have meetings, so they start assisting us at 8. I find a long queue there, so I'm gonna leave the hospital at what, 10, 11. By that time, the first class is over. I'm gonna take the child to back home and then go to school. Imagine, one, that's money, two, that's time, and I didn't have both those, you know, so it was really, really difficult. So guys, it's really rough. It is really, really, I can't emphasize this enough. So yeah, it was one of the things that, yeah, ate me alive. I'm going to cut this video into two parts. So this one is gonna be a part one, and then I'm gonna make a part two in the other one. But I'm gonna have the same intro as well. Anyway, so yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Like, comment. Oh yeah, guys, please comment your experiences. You know, if you have a child, or you know, you've gone through some things, you know, some things obviously I've been through, you know, at a young age, which maybe you've been through at an older age, or you're married and you've experienced the same things. Please just comment down below and we can talk, share with your friends, and I'll see you guys in my next video.